and welcome to my introduction series of scripting for artists. My name is Alexander Richter, and today we want to have a glimpse look into scripting in 3ds Max. So before we dive in, let's have a look in the scripting languages we can script in 3ds Max. So the first one would be MaxScript, which is best used for specialists since it can only be used in 3ds Max. But on the flip side, it's a native language, so it's well integrated and it gives you a quite amount of feedback and help. On the other side, we have Python, which is best used for generalists since you can use it across all the DCC packages you will normally have in VFX and animation, from Maya to Nuke to Katana and so on. But you can say it's some kind of fresh addition. It's already there for some years, but it's still not 100% well integrated. And it provides you with just partially help and feedback. So let's compare both code sides of MaxScript and Python. So we want to open the test.mx. So for MaxScript, we would say load max file, and then we give it in quotes the file path. In terms of Python, we'd first need to import the 3ds Max API. So we say import max plus, and then we say max plus, we want to access file manager, and then we want to use the function open and give it also the path. So let's fire up 3ds Max. And while it starts, let's compare Maya and 3ds Max since they have some similarities, especially in the native language. So in Maya, we have Mel, in 3ds Max, we have MaxScript. And both are native languages in their software packages and have a specific amount of feedback you can use and trigger. So which I will show you. In terms of Python, it's in both an addition. And especially in MaxScript, it's still not very well integrated. And in some parts, you can say it's some kind of train wreck. So if you don't are not used to use Python and still just want to use 3ds Max and help your daily life, I would provide maybe to suggest to go into MaxScript and just look the basics in how to do MaxScript. So let's dive in. So if you look at the menu you have here is scripting tab. If you open it up, you have MaxScript Listener and MaxScript Editor. So the MaxScript Listener is some kind of a console, so it's the output of what you do, and it provides you the options of using MaxScript or Python. So we stay at MaxScript, and you can also type in commands in the listener, but I wouldn't suggest it because then you will mix up input and output. So use it mostly for outputs. On the other side, we have the MaxScript editor, which in one side is a normal file editor, and the other side you can execute directly inside the editor some code. So let's dive in into MaxScript and do something. So we have here then open file code. So to open a file, we say load max file, then space, and in quotes, we say the file path. To execute anything in the MaxScript editor, you either execute the whole file or tab, so you press Control E, or if you want to have a specific selection, just select it and press Shift Enter. So now we executed the load max file, and as you see, we changed to test max and we printed out it's true, so it worked out. So for saving, it's intuitive quite the same now. So it's instead of load max file, it's save max file. So save max file and then a path. Let's execute this one. And now we change the save from test to test two. So maybe now you want to have the scene path. How do you get it? So MaxScript has, besides some functions, of course, variables, and two of them are max file path and max file name. And if we combine it with a plus, we get the scene path and scene name. And if we execute this one, we would get this path here. So it's dtest2max where we currently saved in. So now you ask yourself, like, how do I know all this stuff? There's a lot of functions and variables, and how do I know it? And my first answer would be Google it. If you want to know, for example, the path of your current file, just type in scene path, MaxScript, and one of the first links will provide you probably exactly this line of code, which I used now. The other way, which is the same way of Maya, is doing something, let it print it out, copy it, change it, and then execute it. And it's the same way as you use it in Mel. You have a function here, and it's called the macro recorder. And it's, you can find it in the MaxScript Listener. And if you enable it, it will now record everything you do and print it out as a MaxScript command. So let's do something here. So let's go to create primitive, and let's create a box primitive. So now we create a box primitive. And as you can see, we have already the first code how to create this box primitive with a specific scale and rotation and so on. So let's continue our work. Let's move it a little bit, rotate it, and scale it. And now we are finished, so we disable it. And we have a decent amount of code we now can use to modify as we like. So let's bring it here. And let's do a scale. So we know how to scale now. So we'll put it in a script editor. So the command here is scale. Then it's a dollar sign, which means the current selection. And then we have some variables for X, Y, and Z. So let's double the current size. So select this, shift enter. And as you can see, we doubled the size of the current selection. But what is if you don't select it at the moment and you want to access a specific object in the scene? Easy as that, it's just deselect it. And here you see the name. So it's called box 001. So if you would add to your dollar sign box 001 and then execute this line, you would access the specific object in the scene. So a way of doing this is just replacing the selection with the real name of the object, and then you can access it. And you can use from everything here inside. You can use the move tool to change things. You can use the selection tool to select specific parts of your, you can even create the whole object with that. And this is like the easiest way of accessing MaxScript for you. Just start the macro recorder, do some stuff, copy that, change what you need and how you like it, and then execute the parts which you want to do. So next up would be how to do UI. So now you have your chain of things to do, but you want maybe changes. Sometimes you want to have specific objects and you want to type it in or select them inside a UI. And there's a way. In MaxScript, it's called rollout. And let's have a look of what this would be if we execute this one. So we would create a window with a small rollout inside there. So what did we do? So we say we want to create a rollout. The variable name is now new rollout. The title of this will be new rollout, which is you can see here. And then the size, width and height. And I mean, it would be an empty rollout, so it's nothing there. So let's create a button for there. So button is just inside the rollout, you will say button. Then it will be called button one from now on. And the content of the button would be do something, which is here. Then the position of the button inside this, and then the width and height. But of course, a button with no function is not of a button. So we need to add a callback for that. So we say on button one, we want the press event. And if you press it, do a print here in the backside and open a message box and say, finish doing stuff. So if we press it, we'll get the message box, finish doing stuff. And it will print in the background, the print one. And you can put in a lot of other things, like other MaxScript things, like, for example, move the current selection, change the current selection, and this is the way. And we're not finished here because we just have the rollout, but we don't have a window. So one way would be to do a new rollout floater. We call it big window, set the size here. So this is the whole big thing. And in the end, we need to put the small rollout inside the big window. So we say add rollout, new rollout, button thing. And that's it. And that's like an easy way of creating UI and making accessible for your needs. But on the other side, it's the same way with the macro recorder. You can do it like by code, Googling it in this way, or you can use it visually. And how to do that? So you go into scripting, and here is the visual MaxScript editor. And it's a UI to create your UI. So let's create a very clunky, very fast-paced UI here. So what do we want here? One color picker, checkbox. We don't know, we don't care. So we create it now, and now you can modify how everything is called, what's the size, and so on and so on. When you're finished, you just say file, save as. And then you save it as a MaxScript file. So let's call it new UI and save it. But you're not finished yet, because now it's just, you can't access it at the moment. So what you need to do is to give it a window. So we learned that before. So let's copy the code here. So yeah, we have a big window, and it's called unnamed rollout. So we need to change it here and save it. So yeah. So now we have saved our current UI in a file. So how can we access it? To access any file here, you need to do two things. At first, you need to copy the file into a path where 3ds Max knows there is a script file. And one of the paths 3ds Max is accessing is under C, users, your logging name, app data, local, Autodesk, 3ds Max, then the version, NU, and scripts. It's a mouthful, but this is one of the paths 3ds Max is accessing and waiting for scripts to be there. So if we put our new UI MS inside there, we can access it in our script editor. For example, we want to access this one, which we created now. So we say file in, and then give it a name. And as you can see, we created our monstrosity of a rollout with all the color picker and the checkbox and check button and so on. And this is like the easiest way. Just create in Visual MaxScript Editor your rollout, add it to save it in your script path, and then you can access it. And you can still add buttons and functions to that thing. So in the same way, you can access like code. If you just have, for example, a function. So for example, we have also in this path the load.ms file here. So what's inside there? So we load the max file test. Okay. So the same way how to access this is just to do file in and then say load.ms. So let's access this. And now we change from test 2 to test. And this is like the way of accessing any files and having them inside, instead of always into your script editor, compromised in one file and just use one line of code to add like a bunch of things to your scene. So the other thing I want to mention is, of course, the Python. It will be a little bit smaller since Python is not as advanced as it can be, but let's have a look into that. So first thing we need to do is to import the 3ds Max API. So we say import Max plus, and let's do a save. So we already saved. So let's do a test one. Yeah, and we save test one. And the same way is like Max plus file manager save and Max plus file manager open, you save and open files. So there's a certain situation where you sometimes don't know something in Python, but you know it in MaxScript, because for example, you use the macro recorder and now you don't know what to do because you want to use Python. And there's a way where you can put Python around MaxScript. And the way to do it is use maxplus.core, and then use the function eval maxscript. And inside in quotes, you put in the maxscript command. And if you, for example, want to print something out or have some information, like in this case, the file path, you need to add a .get. So if we would execute this line here, we would get the current file path. And now we use Python with MaxScript inside to execute this line. And if we, for example, know the MaxScript command, we can still use Python for that. And it sometimes can be very, very handy in this case. So the last thing I want to show you is the same thing as in MaxScript. I want to show you how to access external files. A pity thing in Python, especially here in 3ds Max, is Python accesses environment variables, and 3ds Max doesn't work that much with environment variables. So if you want to have an access to a Python file which is in a file, you need to add it as a variable to the current system. So a way to do it is to do an import sys and then say sys path append and then add a path, for example, elx. So here we have elx, and we have here, for example, the save script py. And what's in there? It's just a function, save scene, and just save to test free. That's it. So if we would execute this lines, we say add this path, this folder, and then use the save script for a file and access there the save scene function. So let's execute this one. And as you can see, we changed from test one to test three and saved it as test three. So this is like the basic way of how to work in 3ds Max with MaxScript and Python. And I will highly recommend John Wainwright's MaxScript 101. He's the creator of MaxScript, and also for me was the basic introduction for MaxScript and 3ds Max. I hope you like this video and share it with people who are interested in learning scripting. And I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.